Welcome to the Professional Learning Session, Measuring Stakeholder Satisfaction. Whether you're joining us today as part of earning a micro-credential or just want to learn more about the topic, we're happy you're here and hope this screencast session is engaging, meets your needs, and you to apply what you learned to your work. At the end of this session, there's a link to a satisfaction survey. Please take a few minutes to complete the survey. We appreciate your data and feedback.
Hi there. I'm Amanda Levan, the newest member of the Chief Strategy Office team here at the South Carolina Department of Education. One of my duties as Program Assistant is helping offices develop stakeholder surveys, so I'm happy to be here and share some initial thoughts and examples with you. I will be facilitating the last two outcomes of this screencast.
Each year to improve agency functions, and we were heavily involved in the stakeholder engagement data collection during development of the Every Student Succeeds Act, ESA, Consolidated State Plan in 2017 and 2018. I'll be facilitating the first two outcomes of this screencast. I'd like to introduce my co-facilitator for this session, Amanda Levan. This screencast session is focused on helping you think through how you might measure stakeholder satisfaction for your program or project. By the end of this session, you should be able to articulate why stakeholder satisfaction is important to your program or project, plan a survey design considering critical design questions, plan strong stakeholder satisfaction questions for your program, and plan how you will gather, analyze, and share your stakeholder satisfaction data. First, let's begin with answering the question, is stakeholder satisfaction important? I have some thoughts on that. Surveys provide us with data about stakeholders' attitudes and beliefs, and their perceptions of reality. This is important because those attitudes, beliefs, and perceptions are the primary determinant of stakeholder actions and behavior, which is often what we at the SEDE are attempting to influence or address. You can see from this graphic, based on Trevor Maber's concept of a ladder of inference, that people's actions and behaviors are based on their beliefs. But a great deal happens to formulate those beliefs. Experience they may have with your program or project are first filtered through personal preferences and tendencies, then interpreted based on those personal preferences and pre-existing beliefs. After that, your stakeholders make assumptions and draw conclusions that influence their beliefs, their reality. This then translates into actions and behaviors. Wonder why a brilliant resource or set of guidelines is not being used or is being misinterpreted and used incorrectly, chances are that it has something to do with perception. If we wish our programs to be effective, in other words, change behavior, we must address reality, but also the perception of that reality. Understanding stakeholder preferences, assumptions, attitudes, and beliefs is critical in implementing effective programs and projects. Programs and projects cannot be effective if they are not used or if they are avoided, ignored, or misunderstood by the stakeholders they are intended to affect. Stakeholder perception shapes reality. No matter how much objective data you have that shows your program or project is working or will work, if stakeholders do not perceive that it is working or will work, then their actions and beliefs will run counter to the program and will likely, in the end, reduce or completely undermine its effectiveness. To build and implement effective programs and projects, which inevitably involve stakeholders, we need to think with an outside-in orientation. Often, organizations, perhaps especially state agencies, take an inside-out orientation. We create processes that will work for the organization first. An outside-in orientation means that we, the SEDE, design and implement programs and projects based on the needs of our stakeholders first. In business terms, stakeholders are our customers. Take Shaw's definition of the outside-in orientation. Operating from the perspective of stakeholders involves walking the process as if you were a customer, looking in at the organization through a customer's eyes, enabling a process focused on the needs of the customer or the stakeholder. In government or the public sector, from the inside out, After all, we have our own tendencies, interpretations, and assumptions, and it's our job to implement and monitor legislation. We tend to do that by designing programs and projects focused on the needs of governing, including funding, monitoring, or reporting, and not from a stakeholder's perspective. Our job at the SEDE is to implement legislative mandates with fidelity, but when we implement what works for us, it often does not work for stakeholders. To help ensure effectiveness, we need to design and implement programs and projects with an outside-in orientation. Let's remember to build and implement programs and projects from the perspective of stakeholders focused on an understanding of their needs. That means we have to get stakeholder data, generally through stakeholder satisfaction surveys. Let's take a minute to define the word stakeholder. In the public sector, a stakeholder is a constituent or individual who is likely affected or somehow invested in your project or program. Unlike the business sector, most programs and projects at the SEDE serve multiple stakeholder groups: parents, cafeteria workers, bus technicians, teachers at every certificate level and area, experienced principals, new principals, district superintendents, data specialists, students, business leaders, advocacy groups, legislators, the list is endless. All are likely affected or invested in the many projects and programs across the SEDE. Measuring stakeholder satisfaction is more than just figuring out whether our stakeholders are happy with a given program or project. Here, we are defining the term stakeholder satisfaction widely. In this session, stakeholder satisfaction data are defined as any stakeholder thoughts, feelings, attitudes, beliefs, or opinions related to a program or project. Your overall survey design will determine the aspects of stakeholder data which you will need to gather. Do stakeholders always need to be satisfied? It depends. Is overall satisfaction with your program or project the data goal? Sometimes you just want feedback or information about what stakeholders are perceiving or not perceiving, what they know and what they do not know. However, if you are measuring overall stakeholder satisfaction, the answer to this question is no. Sometimes, especially with unpopular legislative mandates, you may not be able to satisfy all of your stakeholder groups. That said, you always need to know if and when they are not satisfied. What aspect of the program or project is creating stakeholder pain points? Why pain points might be happening? What stakeholder ideas are out there that might help the program or project be more effective? I want you to take a couple of minutes to pause and reflect on this question. How is stakeholder satisfaction important to your program or project? Remember, we're defining stakeholder satisfaction data as any stakeholder thoughts, feelings, attitudes, or beliefs related to your program or project. Jot down your answer and thoughts on a piece of paper so you're really reflecting. Please pause this presentation until you complete the activity, then restart when you're ready. There are a number of ways in which stakeholder satisfaction is important to your program or project. Did you write down any of these? To identify what's working and what needs to work better, to make informed decisions about program development, to measure stakeholders' perception of your program, to gauge agency self-perception against the community's perception, to identify program effectiveness, or to get specific feedback to inform improvement. And don't forget about using an outside-in orientation to ensure program or project success. How many of these are from the customer's point of view? Next, I'd like us to take a look at the use of critical design questions. There are three critical questions that you need to consider when designing a survey to measure stakeholder satisfaction. The first is, who are your stakeholders? Chances are that any SEDE project addresses multiple groups of stakeholders. For example, teachers, parents, business leaders, principals, and superintendents. How these groups differ and what you need to know from each of them will determine how your questions will differ across those groups and why their responses sometimes vary. Because of this, always keep the demographics of your stakeholders, role, geographic location, experience, etc., in mind when you design a stakeholder satisfaction survey. Second, what do you really need to know from your stakeholders? Are you trying to gauge their awareness or understanding of a program or project? Are you trying to get specific feedback to see how the program or project can be improved? Or are you trying to evaluate overall satisfaction? According to the work of Fred Reichheld, the ultimate question to determine stakeholder satisfaction is, how likely is it that you would recommend this company to a friend or colleague? He maintains this single question allows one to track promoters and detractors, producing a clear measure of an organization's performance through its customers' eyes. Reichheld and Markey, 2011, are referenced at the end of this session if you want to know more about focusing satisfaction measurement around a single satisfaction question. In the Chief Strategy Office, we use a similar question as part of our Professional Development Satisfaction Survey to measure overall satisfaction of participants. Finally, the last critical design question is, when do you need to know what your stakeholders are thinking? Do you need it before the program or project begins to ensure your work meets the needs of stakeholders? Do you need it during implementation to check on progress or determine what might need to change? Or do you need stakeholder satisfaction data at the end of the fiscal year or after everything is complete to determine how effectively the program or project performed? I'm going to give you two examples of stakeholder satisfaction surveys to help you consider your own design. I'll be addressing each of the three critical design questions in my examples. My first example has to do with the collection of stakeholder feedback required by federal guidelines. The SEDE worked with stakeholders to write the ESSA Consolidated State Plan, which was first submitted to the United States Department of Education in fall 2017. As part of developing the Consolidated State Plan, we were required to collect and use stakeholder feedback from a diverse variety of stakeholder groups. This survey was used at both face-to-face and virtual stakeholder meetings. Look at the ESSA Stakeholder Exit Survey, which is provided as a separate document with this screencast. Take a few minutes to think about how the example addresses the three critical design questions. Who are your stakeholders? What do you need to know? And when do you need to know it? Please take a look at the example survey, pause the presentation, and restart when you're ready to continue. In response to the first critical design question, who were stakeholders, we collected data from multiple groups per federal guidelines, but we did not need to compare feedback across groups. We documented the diversity of stakeholders through sign-in sheets and meeting types. Because ESSA stakeholders are all equally important, we designed the survey to be generic and applicable across all groups. For the second critical design question, we had several need-to-know items. First, specific open-ended feedback needed to be collected in such a way that it could be compiled by section of the ESSA Consolidated State Plan. This allowed writers of the individual sections to process the feedback, incorporate it as needed, and provide evidence of how the feedback informed or did not inform their writing. Feedback was collected via real-time charting or virtual chat boxes during each meeting, not in the provided exit survey. The exit survey was used to assess how informed the public was about ESSA as the meetings and stakeholder engagement went on. Basically, we wanted to know if our stakeholder engagement outreach was having an effect. We also wanted to know how aware stakeholders were of ESSA's requirements, critical questions that needed to be addressed, and the process the SEDE was using to write the state plan. Finally, using the exit survey, we felt it was critical to assess if stakeholders thought the SEDE was doing a good job collecting and paying attention to stakeholder input. Did stakeholders feel valued and listened to? This was one of our goals for stakeholder engagement under ESSA. As you can see, we designed the exit survey questions to collect much more than just whether stakeholders were happy. In terms of the third critical design question, when do you need to know? We needed to gather specific feedback across all meetings for a final report, but we also needed to compare stakeholder awareness, engagement, and satisfaction between meetings. Because the exit survey was consistent across all meetings, we were able to document how stakeholder awareness and knowledge of ESSA increased over time. My second example has to do with assessing the effectiveness of professional development. In the Chief Strategy Office, we conduct professional learning opportunities both inside the agency and outside the agency. Our generic professional development PD survey can be provided in a hard copy or virtual format, depending on the situation. At the end of this screencast, we'll ask you to complete the electronic version. Virtual surveys are convenient, but hard copy administration to a captive audience can ensure that you get data from every participant, so occasionally you may wish to resort to hard copies. Look at the CSO PD survey, which is provided as a separate document with the screencast. Take a few minutes to think about how the example addresses the three critical design questions. Who are your stakeholders? What do you need to know? And when do you need to know it? Please take a look at the example survey. Pause the presentation and restart when you're ready to continue. In response to the first critical design question, who are your stakeholders? Our stakeholders are various, but we want to make certain our professional development material is targeted, engaging, and effective, no matter the group or session objectives. To that end, we developed a common stakeholder satisfaction survey that we use across all professional development, so comparisons can be made between different series, delivery methods, and time. Our goal was to keep it generic and short, 5 minutes or less, in order to make responding easy on participants. In response to the second critical question, what do you need to know? We want to know if our PD is appropriate to audience need, if participants are engaged, and how effective each session is. To assess effectiveness, we ask stakeholders if they feel they will be able to apply what they have learned and if participation is likely to improve their work. To assess overall satisfaction, we ask whether participants would recommend the session to a colleague. We always want to know how to improve, so we always ask for specific feedback about what worked and did not work for participants during the session. In response to the third critical question, when do you need to know? We use aggregated numerical data from questions 1 through 6 in the overall evaluation of the effectiveness of our professional development, usually at the end of a project or fiscal year. We also collect and look at the data, especially the 2 feedback questions at the end of the survey, to improve and make changes during the course of a given project or year. I hope these 2 design examples help you reflect on how you might create or assess a stakeholder satisfaction survey for one of your programs or projects. If you already use a stakeholder satisfaction survey, this is an opportunity to assess its design. Feel free to look back at the example surveys provided. I hope these critical design questions will help you design future stakeholder satisfaction surveys for your program or project. That said, it's your turn. Take 5 minutes now to review and reflect on an existing survey or design a new stakeholder satisfaction survey. Write down your answers and thoughts in response to each of the critical design questions. Please pause the presentation while you do this and restart when you have completed the activity. Now that you have a good plan for the survey design, Amanda is going to take over and help you plan strong questions.
Hi, it's Amanda again, and I want to share some ideas. Now let's review some basic guidelines for writing. Open-ended questions are used. There are many types of closed-ended questions. Let's take a look at some closed-ended questions in the ESSA. Now let's take a look at the open-ended questions. At this point, you should take a couple of minutes to pause. Now that you have drafted some questions for your survey, you now have a good grasp of why you're collecting your data. Once you have your data collected, there are When analyzing your data, let's talk a little about Let's take a look now at comparing data across. One of the main advantages of pretest post benchmarking is setting a baseline or standard. The type of questions used in your survey determine what level. Let's take a couple of minutes for you to pause and reflect on. Now that you have some draft questions and have a good idea, once the survey results are available, always share your. One example in sharing is the exit survey data. Example 2 is a collaborative slide deck created by. Take a few minutes to think about ways you might want to share. We want to make certain that the stated learning objectives of. Here are references that have been cited. As a reminder, this session, Measuring Stakeholder. Thank you for your time and learning today.